పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృత దుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 6 ఆఫ్ 7 చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ ఏతద్యోనీని భూతాని సర్వాణీత్యుపధారయ అహం కృత్స్నస్య జగతః ప్రభవ ప్రళయస్తథా. ఫ్రమ్ వర్డ్స్ నెంబర్ 4, భగవాన్ హ్యాస్ స్టార్టెడ్ నేరేటింగ్ ద నేచర్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్. ద నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ద గాడ్ హ్యావ్ బీన్ ఇంట్రడ్యూస్డ్ యాజ్ ద టూ ప్రిన్సిపల్స్. One is called Paraprakriti, another one is Aparaprakriti. Aparaprakriti, which is inert as a material. And this Aparaprakriti alone is visible. Paraprakriti, which is in the form of consciousness, it is not visible. So these two principles are known as Ishvara Swarupam. Till the verse number 6, he has given so many knowledge about Ishvara, the concept of the God. In these sessions, I will take you in different way. When we approach the same content in different aspects, it will be easier to assimilate what Bhagavan Krishna teaches here. Now, why should I understand the God? We saw the answer in the last session itself. So then alone, my life gets complete. The first, the self-realization and God realization, both are both sides of a coin called spirituality. And there is no materialistic life and spiritual life. Both are one and the same. So when you live with the growth outside and inside, it's called complete life. And recently people have divided because of foreigners. They have their own perception to see the scriptural life and the normal life. What do you say? Materialistic life is to earn money and earn so many wealth and health, that's all. That inner growth, inner peace only will come by studying spiritual aspects. Therefore, God realization is the very important part in our life. If you are not giving importance to this God realization, your life will become definitely incomplete, I tell you. This God realization has been given as three steps. I can call even three levels. The first level is to accept God as the creator. Why should I accept the God as the creator? Okay, then whom that you think is the creator of this universe? Now, universal, you know, it has become like a Big Bang theory. Suddenly it appeared. Suddenly it is manifested. By what force? Is there any power? I can accept that, you know, what you say right now, there must be some power. What? What kind of power? Now that's what science is digging on. Definitely one day we will find it out. Do you think God is power like electricity? After inventing it, we can use the electricity. We can use the electricity to get more air, wind, fan, air condition, and we can also found refrigerator, radio, and car, bike, and whatever that we can utilize the electricity in different form. In the same way, if we found the power which is known as the cosmic one, we can also use them. It is not possible because this is the cause of your creation alone. Swamiji, please don't pull the leg. No, I'm not pulling the leg. This is what the science is digging off. The power which is the cause of entire universe, do you think you can understand completely? No, we cannot understand completely. At least we can understand a little bit. You are understanding it because electricity is nothing but the glory of the God. See, all the powers are nothing but the glory of the God. That's what 10th chapter says. But you are not grown up to that level to accept everything is nothing but God. Now what Krishna says, there are three levels, sir. It depends on you. Because a baby doesn't know how to realize the God. In fact, everybody knows God doesn't have the form. It is possible. God is, you know, it is all pervasive. And He is omniscient, omnipotent. All these words, they look very nice. How to understand it? When you realize the God, the benefit is all samsara will be gone. No sorrow. No complication in your life. You have to experience only the completeness. By studying Bhagavad Gita only without Guru, just read it, you cannot understand. The God concept must be given in the preliminary stage as the creator. Because the world exists. Go and ask anybody, are you aware the world exists? Then he will say, yes, I am aware, of course, from the childhood. What is the proof? I could see, touch, and I could feel that. Because we believe world can impact me. World can affect me. World can give me happiness, sadness. And world can give me success and failure. This is what our perception is. Now, in order to realize Ishvara, we have to understand God as a creator, or we have to accept, because this world is being created. Of course it is created by some power. Okay, chalo, that some power is the God. And how He created? When it wants to manufacture a car, it gives contract to so many other companies, engine from some other person, and tires are some from other company, and all these electrical things are from other company, body is from some more other companies. Finally, everything is assembled as a car. Is it like that? God has got the contractors. How long He took to create the Jagat? Maybe, you know, centuries or millenniums. No. Tadaikshata bahusyam prajayeti. In a fraction of the seconds, just He had a thought, there would be a world. A srishti. Because He is omnipotent, the glory must be given to Lord. Now the world is created. Where is the creator? We have to fix some place. Otherwise what? We don't have the capacity to understand the God. If you say God is all pervasive, all you know, in and out, the mind won't accept. Therefore, they say God has the place called Vaikuntha, Kailasha, Shripura. So immediately you will look up. Vaikuntha, is there visible? That is invisible. So that in order to reach the Vaikuntha, Vaikuntha is the destination for all Vaishnavas. Ishvara who lives in Vaikuntha, we have to reach there. In order to reach that Vaikuntha, we have to make a journey to the Vaikuntha which is in the earth. There is a భూలోక వైకుంఠ ఇన్ సౌత్ కాల్డ్ శ్రీరంగం. వెన్ యూ గో దిస్ ఫిజికల్ వైకుంఠ శ్రీరంగం, దేర్ రంగనాథ ఈజ్ యునో ఈజ్ లయింగ్ డౌన్, హీ విల్ కనెక్ట్ యూ టు దాట్ వైకుంఠ. ఓకే, దాట్ ఈస్ ద కాన్సెప్ట్. అండ్ దేర్ ఇస్ అ కైలాస ఇన్ నేపాల్ విచ్ వాజ్ ఇన్ ఇండియా లాంగ్ బ్యాక్. నేపాల్ ఆర్ చైనా నౌ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ యు నో ద బోర్డర్స్ ఆర్ కన్ఫర్మ్డ్ నౌ డేస్. భూలోక కైలాస, భూలోక వైకుంఠ. సో ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ హవ్ బీన్ గివన్ అ సిస్టమాటిక్ లైఫ్ సో దట్ వీ కెన్ బీ ఎండౌడ్ విత్ ద ఈశ్వర ఫ్రమ్ ద బిగినింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద లైఫ్. గాడ్స్ ఆర్ గివన్ ఫార్మ్ in order to assimilate the godliness. So when Swami Vivekananda in his childhood, he was provided a toy of Kashi Vishwanath. The Kashi Vishwanatha who was in the form of meditator. So when Naren, he was called Naren, you know, he started playing and pretending like the Vishwanatha himself. Then he developed the habit of meditating. The meditation which he had in the young age, it helped him to concentrate more. And Swami Vivekananda had excellent concentration. The concentration, focused mind is the basic foundation. It has to be the basic foundation of all the education which we learn throughout our life. In the same way, when a form or a small toy is given to the child, maybe as a Lord Krishna, Krishna toy, Lord Ganapati, Ganesha toy, Lord Shiva. So when you give, the form has got the glory. A creator is given the form with a certain rituals which are nothing but a formula endowed with science in it. You can communicate the creator through given form, then mind becomes easier. So your mind will accept this, okay? God is everywhere means where you do namaskara. You cannot communicate because our mind doesn't have the capacity to communicate which is formless. Therefore the forms are given. And given forms are given life by Vedic mantras. And consecration have been done. The God becomes a live object, means subject. Now you can see in that given form, Lord Venkateswara, Lord Balaji, both are same, okay? Lord Sriranga, Lord Parameshwara, Adi Parashakti, Lalita Triprasundari, and Lord Harihara Ayyappa. Whatever the form, for him, he is the creator. When he sees the creator in that statue, the creator comes in that statue and helps. So whom to ask the help? We have to ask the help from the creator itself. Now for a devotee of Venkatachalapati Balaji, the Balaji is the author, creator of the world. So when the form is given to a child, it plays with that, it communicates with that. Communication has the life. Though the toy doesn't communicate with him, but toy exists with the consciousness. Every object is exists with consciousness. That's what we saw, paraprakriti, aparaprakriti. Now that boy who used to play with the toy, Lord Krishna or Ganesha, whatever the toy, he played with, after certain period of time, when he grows to be an adult, that he will throw, then the toy will be there in the storeroom, doesn't matter. Then this boy is attracted to the world and he goes among the world, he gets more educated and educated wrongly, okay, educated, and he gets married, he goes for a job. And he has a kind of communication with the world. But whatever the expectations that he has, it's not fulfilled with the world. world gives back some kind of competition. He doesn't know the shelter where he can rest. He goes in a temple. That temple is Lord Krishna's temple. Then when he looks at the form Lord Krishna, because he was provided in engage Lord Krishna, before entering the worldly things, the Krishna had entered in his buddhi. Now Krishna, the toy was thrown, the communication with the Krishna exists inside, the Krishna exists in the form of communication. Now that Krishna, when it is in front of him in the temple, automatically eyes are setting the tears. The communication is connected now. Now he could catch hold the Krishna, finds the shelter. That's what the glory of Saguna Upasana, Rupa Upasana. Accepting God as the creator, definitely he is the creator. And looking for the God, this is the first level of understanding. A successful life. And you know, you need not to study Bhagavad Gita, you need not to study scriptures. You just, if you are able to believe that God is a creator, you will be provided whatever you want. What else we need? But one thing. So when you are able to believe, your mind doesn't have the capacity to have a constant belief. If some other problem comes, the belief goes down. Therefore, you have to be supported by the inquiry which I told in the last session itself. That is known as the second level. The first level, and especially, you know, when you give toy, means the God's toy to the child, it will start communicating with that. It will be very helpful for that boy's life. But nowadays, what do we give to play to our kids? We give teddy bear. If a kid is communicating with the teddy bear, okay, so how he will grow like? That's all. So therefore, we were very careful in engage. Even giving a toy, from that point we have to insist the concept of the God, so that that boy will grow with the godliness. His life will be the secured life, supported by the godliness. That's what our parents' duty. Priority to be given society. Society is nothing but what? It has to depend on the God. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Pujas. So many glories have been introduced in our Sanatana Dharma. If you love Krishna, Krishna has got separate paddhati, method to worship. If you love Venkateswara, separate paddhati. And I don't want to have Krishna, Venkateswara. Mahavishnu is there. In Mahavishnu, every deity comes together. Lord Shiva is there. No God fights with each other. So everything, it has got its own message. The second level is to give more clarity. If you accept the Venkateswara is the creator, means when you go to Ranganatha, you will get a little bit confused. How to accept this? This is the second level. Called, first one is called Ekarupa Bhakti, accepting God as a creator, as Upadana, Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana Ishwaraha. The God is the cause, material and intelligent cause is nothing but God. That God is my God. Then the second level understanding, if Venkateswara is my God, and what about other God? They are not God. Then the second level comes. So God, as we learnt, has got two principles, the world and consciousness. means matter and consciousness. Matter which is endowed with energy. Energy is not the God. Energy also is inert. Now the second concept is the Parinami Bhada. God is nothing but Parinami Upadana Karana Ishwaraha. So now God, after creating the world, He become one with the world. Now you see, God and world are not different. God exists exactly in the world. Therefore, every object has got the consciousness. Now the material and consciousness cannot be separated. Now material is depending on the consciousness. The consciousness is known as Paraprakriti. This is second level understanding. God has become world. The best example is curd. You know, when you put little bit curd in the milk, now milk has fermented. Now it has become curd. If somebody says, it was once upon a time milk, the basic material of curd is milk. And people say, no, I cannot accept. Show the milk now. Like that, God has become world. Show the God now to me, like Hiranyakashipu. Prahalada says, every single bit of atom, God exists. You take curd and somebody says, you know, every drop of curd has the milk in it. Now milk has become curd. But this has to be understood in the mind or buddhi, like God has become world. You cannot reverse the curd to be a milk. We need not to. That understanding. Therefore, the world need not to be revered as the God, because world is none other than God. This is the second level of understanding, so that in our Sanatana Dharma, we can worship God in any form, because all forms in the creations are not away from the God. A tree can be worshipped as the God. Okay? You need not to give the form in the tree. As the tree, I have seen in so many places, you know, peepal tree and the neem tree, if they are together, it's worshipped. Haldi, turmeric, worshipped as Lord Ganesha. So like so many, even rock can be worshipped, the God can be invoked in all the materials, because already godliness means God exists there. This is a second level understanding. The Parinami Upadana Karana Ishwaraha. God as the world. He has become the world. So it's a beautiful system. So this understanding you can see in the fourth coming verses, especially in the 10th chapter. You get everything is Lord, everything is Ishvara. Masa naam marga shirtoham ratu naam kusum akaraha. So many things, you know. Pandavanam dhananjayaha Ashvattha sarva vrikshanam. So many things, you know. The world is nothing but God. This is second level of understanding. For that, you should have finished the first level. Okay? You should have the accepted God as the creator. Now, creator become one with the created world. This is second level of understanding. Then what about the third level of understanding? That is far beyond our understanding, okay? The third level understanding, what exists is nothing but the God. Wow! It's a classical punch. What exists is nothing but God. How you said God became world? That is second level understanding. But the reality is, what exists is only God. Not one God. Only God. My Gurunatha says, what exists is only God. What about the world? World exists like when you dream, your dreamt world, it has got its own existence, but after getting up, the world doesn't. During the dream itself, dreamer is satyam, true. He is a proper alive object, satyam. The dreamt world, in the during itself, it has false reality. In the same way, while living itself, what exists? Only God. These all name and forms are having false reality. And they are not separate from the God. Like the dreamt world is not separate from the dreamer. Only thing is, when we dream, at that time we believe the world is satyam, but which is false. In the same way, this is third level. Third level, you know, we have so many chapters in order to reach the third level. Now you may get confused. Oh, so how it would be if everything is God, then why we have all this nonsense? That it is, you know, for that alone we have to study. We have to keep study with the confident and with lots of Shraddha. Okay, so this which I have introduced today, it can be the foundation. The concept of the God has been implied in all our rituals, in all our worships, in all our part of our life. Now you can see everything is meaningful. A water can be worshipped. Rasao hamapsu kaunteya prabhasme shashi surya yoho. I think it comes in few verses later. A water can be the God, sun can be the God, air can be the God, because nothing is other than or away than the God. And we will continue. This understanding will help us to successfully assimilate what Krishna teaches. From next session, we will begin where we left in the last session. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.